There's always going to be challenges.
Oh, yes. Time is money, and money and time can run out pretty quickly.
Yeah, so let's see what's in store for our buyers on today's show.
Coming up, I see a beautiful Leicestershire bungalow lies out of the quagmire.
It's just mud, and it's a good job I had. My wellies in the car.
Will this three-bed mid-terrace in Chesterton, Staffordshire, allow me to access all areas?
And this three-bedroom 30 semi in Thornton Heath, Surrey, puts me through my paces in the back garden.
That's what you call a garden, a long one at that.
All these properties have been sold at auction, and we'll find out who bought them and what they paid for them when they went under the hammer.
Latby is a beautiful village on the outskirts of Leicester. Traditionally, it's a farming village, but in recent years, Latby's become a very popular place for commuters as it's less than 6 miles from Leicester city centre.
On the outskirts of my hometown, in this lovely village with some really pretty houses, is the lot I'm here to see. It's not a house, it's a plot of land. Had a guide price of £125,000 and it's down this driveway. Let's have a look.
Mud, glorious mud. Nothing quite like it for cooling the blood. So follow me, follow, down to the hollow, and there let us wallow in glorious mud.
Set back off the main road, down a long driveway. It's just mud, and it's a good job I had my wellies in the car so I can wade through all this mess. But what I can tell you about this plot of land is there's plans in place for three separate properties already. Two beds, which are going to be situated in that area, and a four bed separately over there as well. Lots of off-street parking. It's bigger than I thought it was. But subject to planning, of course, and your choice, you could put four townhouses in a row across that back fence. There's enough space as well to have your two semi-detached properties over there. I think you could be onto a winner and a bit of a money spinner, if that's what you're thinking.
We called in an auction house expert to get some insight into the village and valuations of the planned properties. Bet he wished he'd worn his wellies, like me.
Rappy, really nice village. It's located on the north side of Leicester, about 5 miles from the city centre. Real nice community feel to the village. A couple of nice little pubs, good local little primary school, and really close to the motorway network, so really good for commuting.
It all sounds idyllic. So what if you were to stick to the current outline plan for two-bed semis and a four-bed detached house? What would they be worth?
I feel the two-bedroom semi-detached properties will be worth in the region of £145,000 each, and the larger four-bedroom detached property would have a value in the region of £275,000 to £300,000.
If you were to get the site for anything like the £120,000 guide price, even if you take into account building costs, there's still room for a good profit here, as those sale prices total nearly £600,000. And there's more.
If this plot of land isn't big enough for you, you actually get an additional plot, a smaller plot, a few metres that way. Now, there's no access to it at present, but if you're nice to your neighbours, that could all change and does give this venture and this site so much more potential.
Let's see who's ready to wade in, feet first, at auction.
Lot number 5, 120, excellent prospect. 115 I've got, thank you, at £115,000. 116 is bid here. 116, 117 I've got, 118, at £118,000. 119, 120.
It's a slow start, but once they begin, the bids come in thick and fast. We rejoin the bidding at £138,000.
Against you at the back, £138,000, half, 138 and a half, 139, 139 and a half. No, £139,000 here. One more quickly. For the first time at 139. For the second time at 139. Third opportunity, we're selling it. £139,000. Sold at 139, thank you.
Although our cameras couldn't catch him at the auction, the successful bid was made by Colin. At £139,000, he bought the plot for himself and his wife, Sue. They've lived in Ratby for many years and have close family ties here. We met to discuss their intentions. Colin, nice to meet you.
Morning, Dale.
Sue, nice to meet you. Nice. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Nice to be back home in Ratby. I recognise the accent. It's like going home to see the family. Tell us about the auction first and foremost.
It was frightening. First auction I've bid on for myself. We'd actually offered more before the auction than we got it for at the auction.
Really, you offered more for this?
Yeah, we offered direct and they said no. And we couldn't go to what he wanted, so we went to the auction. Yeah, we're over the moon.
So tell us why particularly this piece of land and this area.
I was born here, and my husband, when we first met, he loved it here. Uh-huh. So he always wanted to live here anyway. And because we've sold our house in Ratby, we desperately wanted to stop here. And so he thought, well, how about building our own? It's our dream.
I have a dream.
The house Colin and Sue sold was a seven-bedroom Georgian mansion. Part of the dream is to give some capital from the sale of the house to the children to extend their houses. By staying in Ratby, they hope to be able to spend a lot more time with the grandkids.
This apparently used to be the brickworks.
Okay.
Years ago, but we didn't know it was here. And we're like winning the pools for us because we want to stay here.
Because it's nice and private as well.
Yes, exactly. That's true. Yeah, winning the pools. I just said winning the pools. That's going back sometimes. So now it's yours. I know there's plans for a four-bed property and two-bed properties. That's already in place.
We've altered that. We've submitted plans yesterday for just a bungalow just for us.
Oh, just one property.
One large bungalow.
Oh, that'd be amazing.
It's large.
It will be large on this big plot of land.
We're worried now we've seen the size of the land. The bungalow is large, but we hate gardening.
Yeah, might have to have a swimming pool.
Oh, now that would be a blow for you, wouldn't it, hey? Having to have a swimming pool.
Just to get rid of some land.
I think she's gone wrong.
Did you hear that? Just nudge that one in nicely there.
So we were amazed we got the land. It's where we want to be. We're now terrified because we've never done anything like this.
That's understandable. It's a big plot.
Just run and scare.
And it needs a lot of clearing. What kind of bungalow are we having? Tell us more about the bungalow, the specifics of the bungalow.
It's large. It's going to be approximately 22 metres long, 10.5 metres deep. It's a dormer bungalow, but it's all oak, all the front's oak. All by folding doors. Our master suite's got a big oak frontage on.
Juliet balcony.
It's going to be what we want. Yeah, a bit of romance. Yeah, no, Colin. it's what we want, but it's all down to budget now.
It's a bit unknown, really. Yeah. We're just getting prices at the moment.
Okay. We're having two prices. We're having the price to build it, finished, complete.
Yeah.
And we're having a price to put the shell up in the footings, and then I'll use my friends and we'll do it bit by bit.
I have a dream.
The couple had looked in vain for a ready-built bungalow, but found builders were more commonly building townhouses these days to maximise the profit from the plot, which is something Colin and Sue aren't too concerned about. What about the budget?
The budget initially was £170,000. We've already revised that.
It's not possible.
No, for what we want. For what we want. So we revised it to £210,000.
Okay.
So we're looking at spending about £350,000 with the land and the build. That's what we're not looking to make a profit.
No.
We're looking it's ours.
To build a home.
Yeah.
For yourself.
It's ours. So the budget is important, but it's not the end value.
No, of course.
In cash, it's the end value because it's for the rest of our lives.
Okay. And you've got people that you're turning to now to get quotes from?
Yeah, I own a mortgage brokerage.
Yes.
So I do a lot of finance for builders.
Okay.
And we're using them, they're quoting us. So using contacts.
So that's your full-time job?
Yeah.
And this is going to be a bit of a project for you, Sue. What do you do yourself away from?
I'm a merchandiser.
Ah, okay. So you'll be...
So I'm part-time anyway.
Okay.
So I'll be there when it's painting and decorating.
All the pretty stuff.
Yes.
And how long are you hoping the work's going to take? What's our kind of timescale from now, from what we see here?
to your dream family home?
We was hoping like 6 months, but now we've decided it'll be 6 to 9 months, and we don't really know the time schedule, because even like the utilities, we didn't realise how long you have to wait for that to get in. So it's a little bit unknown, but hopefully this time next year we will be in our bungalow.
I think you've done well. I think you've done really well to find a plot of this size in an area that you both love.
Yeah, definitely.
Where your family are.
We're very fortunate, we know that.
You're going to feel at home.
And for the price.
You're going to feel at home. There's another little hidden gem that you get with this property as well, isn't there?
Yeah, it's stuck behind, it's landlocked behind next
door's.
Yeah, yeah, just behind next door's garden, but we're not particularly, but this is big enough.
Yeah.
If we could get that, it'd be lovely. We'd so we'd like to put a pool in there, as you mentioned earlier.
Swimming pool, play area for the blankets.
But if the neighbour don't want to sell, we're not bothered. It can just sit there. It's not doing anything.
Yeah.
It's not costing anything.
And see, this is
more than enough. Big enough.
You're sort of building like a family base, aren't you? Not just a base for you guys, but a family base that everybody can
come down. And, well, they do anyway. They're always down.
Yeah, we're having a big New Year's party, aren't we, for the family?
Having an Oscars party.
Yes.
Are you?
Farewell to that.
Yes, exactly.
Champagne and tux.
Oh, fantastic. Well, listen, I know...
You're not invited.
That was my next question. Is it in the post? Is mine in the post?
Yeah.
I hope you're both very happy. I really hope you do well. So, good luck to you. Good luck to you. Congratulations, Colin.
Good luck.
Colin and Sue, very excited about their new venture. A little bit of nervousness as well, but they found a plot of land in an area they know very well, with all their family around them. Will they get that family base they've wanted for many years? And will it have a swimming pool? You can find out later on in the programme.
Up in the morning and out to school.
Chesterton is a former mining village in Staffordshire, about 3 miles to the north of Newcastle-under-Lyme. As well as its proximity to larger towns like Castle, as it's known around these parts, there are also a number of schools and colleges close by, making the village very popular with young families.
So, a very elevated position for the property I'm here to see. You've got this sort of bank down to the road. I wouldn't want to have to mow that, maybe get a few pet goats or something. But anyway, £55,000 plus was the guide price for this. It's a mid-terrace, 3 bedrooms. Now, first thing you'll notice is it's got 2 doors. So we're going to try an experiment, a first on Homes Under the Hammer. Interactive television. Do you want me to, number 1, go through that door, or number 2, go through that door? All you have to do is get your TV remote control and push 1 or 2. Ready? Go. And the results just in. Looks like I'm going through door number 1. So much for interactive television, eh? Through the front door. I don't know what that other door was. But anyway, brief moment while we wait for those people who accidentally retuned to a different channel. Welcome back. So what have we got? Stairs up to the bedroom, 3 bedrooms there. You've got the lounge on that side, and then through to a sort of small, what I suppose would be a sitting room on this side. And the first thing you notice is, oh my golly gosh, look at this. decorative plasterwork on the walls. Actually, it's really, really hard. I mean, if you had a child falling on that, I think they might actually even hurt themselves. So you'd want to replaster that for sure, at least skim it. Looks like we've got new radiators, which is good. Floor seems to be okay. However, in a lot of areas around here that were places where a lot of mining went on, some of the excess stuff from that mining actually ended up as the sort of stuff underneath floors, and over time that can cause a bit of a problem. So you definitely need to have that checked out, because it would give you a potential problem if you're trying to get a mortgage. But through here, through into the kitchen, through this little archway, I mean, it's crying out for a bit of thought, this, isn't it? You can take out the whole of that wall, perhaps, to create yourself a really nice kitchen living space, because you've not only got this, but you've got this sort of little thingy. Oh, let's incorporate it in the kitchen and create a really nice space. Because what we got back here? Aha! A door. The mystery is solved.
Now, I know I'm always banging on about ex-local authority properties, but this is good, solid housing stock. OK, there may be an issue with the floor, but on the whole...
Well, yeah, more decorative plasterwork up here. Lovely. But three bedrooms, so quite a lot of space. Nice-sized bedroom there. Another good-sized double on that side here. And then today starts to get into the area where we might be able to do a bit of jiggery-pokery and do something quite dramatic. Because at the moment, you've got this little loo here. Very big cupboard, which just contains the boiler, but lots of space. So I wonder if you could get stick a combi boiler down in the kitchen, free up that area, because that is the separate bathroom. It's got a shower in it. But I think maybe playing around with some stud partition walls in here to create a really nice family bathroom. Definitely something needs to be done. Play around with it on a piece of paper and then connect to it.
Scope for some creativity upstairs then, but what about the outside?
Well, at the back of the property, a real nice surprise. Not only have you got this really pleasant tiered garden, but you've also got rear access. Now, no garage at the moment, but you can easily build one. What somebody's obviously got is this car pit here. So, you know, not too much work to get something really useful there. And then you've got that off-street parking, lots of space. And, you know, looking at the back as well, house doesn't look in too bad condition. So, all in all, lots of ticks.
But let's see what a local property expert makes of what's on offer here for a guide price of £55,000.
The property offers three good-sized bedrooms, also two reception rooms downstairs. It's also got a very good elevated garden to the rear of the property. The property does require some general updating throughout, and there's also the option of knocking through to have an open-plan kitchen down.
How does he feel about reconfiguring the upstairs to create a bigger bathroom?
I think the layout upstairs I would leave as it is. You wouldn't need to sacrifice one of the bedrooms if it was to be put in as a more modern bathroom suite.
On to values now.
If the property was modernised to a good standard, we would look to place the property for sale in the region of £85,000 to £90,000. If the property was placed onto the rental market, we would look to achieve somewhere in the region of £450 per calendar month.
We'll clarify the situation with the floor, and I reckon this place could be a real winner. It's a good house in a good location, nice garden, and doesn't need too much work to get it up to scratch. Play your cards right, and this place could definitely bear fruit. Let's see who bought it when it went under the hammer.
Lot 85. What's this, 50 to start me? 50 bid, thank you, at £50,000. 51 can I see now? At 50,000, 51 now, 51. 52, 53, 54, 55, 56, 57, next to you, 58, 59, 60, 61, 62, 63, 64, 65, 66, 67, 68, 69, at 69, with you, sir, at £69,000. 70 anywhere else? Back in, 70, 71, 72, 73, no, 73,000. Your bid, sir, £73,000. 74 anywhere else? 74, 75, sure? 75, still with you, sir, £75,000 once, £75,000 twice, third and final time, £75,000. You bought it, sir. Well done.
Well, that was fun. Nothing beats the spot of quickfire auction tennis, and it was Bill and Sue that hit the winner with that £75,000 bid. I met them back at the house to find out their plans.
And I want you, ooh, want you bad.
Sue, Bill, great to meet you both.
And you.
Hi. Congratulations.
Great.
Tell me why you wanted to buy this house.
Well, this is a long-term investment. So, this is a later on in life pension.
Mm-hmm. And why here and why this particular house?
The house is bigger, it came at the right price.
Yeah.
So I thought, well, why not?
You're both local? Or?
Yeah, we live local.
Right, okay, what do you do when you're not doing this?
Publican.
A publican, oh, you run a pub? Both of you?
Yeah.
Yeah, oh, well, great fun. So what sort of tempted you into the world of property development?
Well, it's not the first one.
Okay.
We've done about...
We've done three, haven't we, all together?
Third one, the third one we do one. Now.
We've sold two, we live in one, and this is an investment.
What attracted you specifically to this one?
After about 6 months of actually going to the auctions, and not getting nothing and nothing, and this one came out and we thought, oh, this might be the one. So we came out and look, we viewed it, read the legal pack, thought, oh, we'll crack at it, we'll try this one.
So what's your involvement going to be in the whole project?
Decoration.
Right. So you're going to get rid of the bumbly walls,
yeah,
and everything everywhere.
Yeah. And Bill will put the back work into it.
Right.
Yeah, try.
Tell me what you're planning to do with it then.
Plaster, hopefully top to bottom. New coat of paint, new kitchen fitted. The bathroom has got a modernist looking shower in there, so I'm not sure about the shower, whether I'm going to rip it out or, because it's going to be a rental, long-term rental, yeah, we might just see how it goes on the viewings. If people are saying, oh, we prefer a bath, then I'll come back in a week's time and I'll chuck a bathroom suite in.
And what about the kitchen side of the downstairs? Obviously, you've got the sort of dining room separate and you've got that little rear area.
Yeah, well, when the plaster comes in, we're going to see what we can do. I mean, whether to open it up and make it one big...
like a kitchen
open diner.
Nice.
Maybe that'll be the plan. Hopefully. Fingers crossed we can go that way.
With plenty of experience behind them, Bill and Sue will tackle most of the work themselves. Bill's speciality is DIY, and Sue will take care of the painting and decorating, but they will leave the plumbing, electrics and gas to the professionals. But there is one job they're not convinced needs to be done at all.
So what about the floor? Because there was a mention of it,
yeah,
wasn't there,
right
in
on
the...
Well, we first looked at all the pack. We asked about the radon test certificate.
So obviously, it's radon, as far as you're concerned, not... problems with the substrate.
Yeah.
Radon is a radioactive gas which comes from naturally occurring uranium underground. In some areas of the country, it's concentrated to very high levels. Public Health England published an online map of the affected areas, but I'm told radon is not something of a major concern locally. However, red ash is, and that can mean digging up and replacing the floor. Either way, both issues need to be sorted if you have them, and both cost money.
So what's the budget?
The budget is going to be around 5,000, give or take a little bit.
Yeah. Yeah.
And what's the timescale?
8 to 10 weeks.
Oh, wow. Because,
Time
is money, so that you get people in as soon as possible.
Yeah, this is only the second time we've been here since we've had it, so...
Yeah.
Well, listen, congratulations. Good luck with it.
Thank you very much.
Well, I think Bill and Sue have got themselves a really nice property here. However, I'm a little bit concerned about the floor. What exactly is the problem? Definitely needs to be investigated. Hopefully, it won't cause them too many hiccups. You can find out how they get on later in the show.
Still to come, three options to extend, upwards to the roof, out at the back and over the garage.
This option gets my vote.
And Bill and Sue see the funny side of their schedule.
I think we could have done it for 10 weeks, but because they're all delayed.
Back now to my old stomping ground, Leicester, and the nearby village of Ratby, where earlier I viewed this 0.34 of an acre site bought by Colin and Sue for £139,000. The plot had outline planning permission granted for three houses, but Colin and Sue had other ideas.
We submitted plans yesterday for just the bungalow, just for us.
That'd be amazing.
It's large.
It will be large on this big plot of land.
We're worried now we've seen the size of the land. We hate gardening.
Yeah, might have to have a swimming pool.
The pool would be a big hit with the grandchildren who live nearby, but it would also be a big hit on the budget. Colin was keeping his options open when it came to construction costs.
We're having two prices. We're having the price to build it, finished, complete,
yeah,
and we're having a price to put the shell up in the footings and then I'll use my friends and we'll do it bit by bit.
They hoped, dependent on the speed of planning, to be in within 12 months, with the physical work scheduled for 6 to 9 months and the spend of £210,000.
The budget is important, but it's not the end value.
No, of course.
In cash, it's the end value because it's our for the rest of our lives.
Okay.
It's our dream.
With their 7-bedroom mansion sold, Colin and Sue moved in with their daughter while work proceeded. And we're back 13 months later to find out if they're living the dream. Looks like Archie's enjoying catching up with Grandma on all the current affairs. Sue got her bifold doors in the kitchen, lounge and dining room, not to mention the pop-up extractor fan. They say, if you're gonna dream, dream big. Well, this dream is 8 meters tall, 10.5 meters deep, and 22 meters long with cavernous rooms. The dining room could easily be a bedroom if needed. It's not as if the kitchen isn't big enough to eat in. The family bathroom serves 2 ground floor bedrooms and the study. Not quite ready for filming yet, but it could easily convert to a further bedroom. But the planning application was for 3 bedrooms, 2 down here and 1 in the dormer. At the rear of the kitchen is the utility room. That concludes the downstairs rooms. Now let's go upstairs to the minstrel gallery. At the far end of the house, above the garage, is the master bedroom. With the Juliet balcony and high-quality light fittings, there's no prizes for guessing who sleeps here. The adjoining ensuite, like everything in the house, is fitted with the finest quality. But there were some unexpected complaints about the quality of fittings. The plumber had never encountered a high-quality waterfall shower before and had to learn how to fit it. But wouldn't we all go through a steep learning curve to end up with a dream house just like this? Catch me when I fall. However, this dream started as a nightmare.
We had to have 17, 20 ton lorries to clear the land. People have been dumping here forever and ever. That, along with us having to get the planning permissions altered, and then having to go 2 metres deep with the footings and have a blocking beam floor, it took our contingency monies within the first month of £20,000. Quite frightening, wasn't it?
Oh, definitely.
Checks on the land at this wet site meant a conventional foundation was out the question, and the extra cost of block and beam caused some casualties.
Afraid the swimming pool money went.
I'm quite glad, because I can't swim. So it was of no interest to me.
But it wasn't all financially bad. As the bungalow is a new build, Colin can claim back the VAT on certain things.
Probably £30,000-£35,000 worth of goods bought. So we're talking probably, I'm probably going to get about £10,000-£15,000 VAT back.
Colin planned on a £210,000 build cost, but with the extra expense of clearing the land, how did that affect the budget?
Final figure on the spend, disregarding the driveway, is £370, so that's £230 to build.
Less the £15,000 VAT due back, I make that £215, £5,000 over, but I'm not arguing. There's no way Colin and Sue would consider selling their dream home, but we called in 2 property experts to establish whether the bungalow was worth the money they had spent on it so far. First, the representative from the auction house who sold the site.
Really impressed with it. They've done an amazing job. They've built a very individual and unique property for themselves and finished it to a really high specification.
I think it's an extremely special house. It's been done to a so high standard that, to be fair, I love it that much, I think I'd buy it.
The couple bought for £139,000. They spent £215,000, including the VAT refund, on the building. They reserved £30,000 for landscaping and laying of the driveway, so a total of £384,000 is the magic figure to beat.
If the property was placed on the market for sale, I'd expect it to achieve in the region of £450,000.
It's a difficult one because it's so early finished, but I think if it went on the open market for sale, we should put it on at £450,000, but offers over, and then let the market decide what they're willing to pay for it.
We are bothered that it's worth what we've spent on it, but we're not really bothered on a profit because it's our home, isn't it?
Yeah, that's all we were worried about in case we probably went over.
Yeah,
really,
we had good quality fittings,
yeah,
didn't we?
Yeah, so we could have gone over, really.
Yeah, but as long as it's worth what we spent, so we're happy with that.
Yeah, that's good.
With retirement on the horizon, are there any further property plans?
We're just going to enjoy it.
Enjoy the
house. Yeah, we've worked all our life.
Done.
Yeah, we've
get
worked all our life for this, haven't we? It's our dream, so we're now going to enjoy our dream.
I'm sure we'd all like to wish Archie and his family many sweet dreams to come.
Thornton Heath is a district of South London that has easy access to green space and great commuter links to the city centre. It sits between Norbury and Croydon, and I've been in this area a lot recently.
Got to get the old tuxedo pressed, got to sew a button on my vest, cause tonight I got to look my best, Lulu's back in town.
As you can see from the properties around me, it's dominated by the 1930s semi. Well, I'm here to see a three-bedder, and it had a guide price of £350,000. It's got off-street parking and a garage, which is such a good start. Usually, I like these houses, so let's hope it lives up to expectations. Oh, I do like this 30s front door and hallway heaven inside. Wow, look at this! I always go on about having a spacious hallway, and look at the staircase. That's really, really nice. So there's a lot to work with straight away in this property. Two reception rooms, great size in here. Second reception room, again, very dated, as you'd expect. And a 1930s kitchen. We're a little bit on the small side here. Terribly disappointing. Right the way round here, we've got the garage through here, a downstairs loo, and a massive utility room. Now, I wasn't expecting this. I suppose you could think about knocking this wall down and opening it up and having a much bigger kitchen. I mean, I wouldn't recommend that you have the same size utility as the kitchen, but there's a lot you could play with. So far, so good. What a surprise, eh? Excited, but on a lovely summer's day like today, I just want to show off this fabulous garden. The house is large inside, but the garden just goes on and on. We're not there yet. And on. There's a bit more still. Come on, keep walking, cameraman. Well, the reason why I'm chivvying you along is because, look, there's even more garden. And this is like a little secret area underneath the undergrowth. Here we are, more of it to talk about. Oh, just getting through here. But look, I mean, if you were thinking about cultivating something amazing with all this space, dun, dun, dun. Well, you could, couldn't you? That's what you call a garden, a long one at that. If you wanted a veg patch here, I reckon you could feed the entire street.
My favourite vegetable.
Failing that, it's ideal for a family. Imagine the kids making dens at the bottom of the garden. In either case, there's plenty of space to extend without compromising the back garden. If you wanted to go down a more cost-effective way of extending, what about extending over the garage here? This is generally a cheaper route than building from the ground up because you shouldn't need to dig new foundations, although building control will still want to check that the existing ones are adequate. Now, one thing to bear in mind, though, that if the walls existing of the garage are only single skin, they might need to be upgraded to match the rest of the house. Now, I have seen that some of the neighbours, well, they've already gone over the garage and they've already done this. And if you did want that fourth bedroom and ensuite, this option gets my vote. It all depends how far you want to develop this. At the side, at the back, even up into the loft, there are many options here. But if you're doing this as an investment, then best pick the brains of a local estate agent.
I'd extend to the rear by the maximum possible. The easiest way to do that is go by permitted development and extend by 3 metres to the rear of the property and maybe make the kitchen and living room at the back of the property a big, nice open plan space.
With this footprint, it could make a large open plan space. What sort of figure would you expect on the open market after refurbishment?
Renovated as a three-bedroom house, this property would sell for approximately £480,000.
Well, 1930s properties usually get a thumbs up from me, but this one is just so spacious. And if you want to make it even bigger, well, there are ways in which you can do that too. So who saw the potential? Let's head to auction and find out.
Right, lot 11 would like kick-off on this. How much? 350, 355, 355, 360, yeah? 365, yes. 370.
Two bidders don't want to be outbid. We rejoin the contest at £428,000.
430 back in, 432. 432, sir. 434. Quick, one more go. 434. 436, sir. 438. 440. 440, 442. 442, 444 elsewhere, if not, 442, first time, second time, third and last time, have you all done? So 442, well done, start and finished it.
The successful bid came from Shaz. Shaz has been on the show before when he bought this three-bedroom semi in Streatham back in December 2014. And to say he had set a very ambitious timescale would be an understatement.
Hopefully we can get it straight on the market.
Because you are thinking about selling it on.
Yeah, I've spoken to one of my friends. He wants to put an open day 3 days from now.
What?
Shaz did have an offer on open day, but decided to rent out, getting a yield of 5%. Today, he's brought his inspiration, his father, along to view the latest £442,000 purchase.
And I'm so happy you've bought the great man himself today, because the last time we met, you really were very much talking about your family and how property developing has been a thing that your dad taught you.
That's right, yeah.
Is that right?
Yes, well, I was taught by my dad, and, you know, it's passed on since the generations. Property that dad raised was about $3,000 for a six-bedroom house, plumbing, central heating, you name it, and I was doing it.
How much of that are you doing here?
Yeah, well
it's
luckily...
It's changed a bit over the years.
I've worked out sometimes it's better to pay somebody else to do it, and it keeps me... I can relax a bit more.
And the faster they can finish the job, the quicker I can move on to sell it and move on to the next project. I mean, for me, I really enjoy making the deals. You get deals made and sold, and within 6 months, you can get, you know, substantial profit.
Overall, days were sort of hard work and difficult, and it was a little money involved, but now it's a lot of money and a little work, so it's worth that way.
I love that. There's a lot of money and a little work. That's how your dad sees it these days.
Definitely.
So how involved are you going to be in this project?
He plays a consultant role and a finance role as well, so occasionally if I need some finances sorted out, he will help out with that.
So you're still there. The bank of mum and dad never ends, does it? So, Shaz, I'm really intrigued to find out what your plans are for this house.
This road is popular because of the side extension. Because we can build on the side, and the rear gardens are very big, so we can build a nice big 6 metre extension, and you could put a loft conversion here. So you could convert this property from a three bedroom to a five bedroom with massive open living space.
And I take it that is what you're going to do?
Yeah, we've already put plans in, and whatever the plans are, they're more or less under permitted development. So we expect to get the permission for that. So.
Shaz isn't concerned about losing the garage, which he feels is too narrow for a modern family car. Several houses in the street have already extended, knocking down the garage. The previous owners of this property had only owned it for a short period of time, which caused Faz, Shaz's mortgage broker, some problems.
The previous sellers were actually just purchased the property a month ago. So I wasn't able to get a mortgage straight away, and it was a lot of hassle getting the mortgage in place.
So he managed. So well done, Faz.
Yeah, he's a very close friend of mine. Actually, I consider him my best friend right now.
Shaz was lucky. The Council of Mortgage Lenders advised members not to lend on properties owned for less than 6 months. And this is to help prevent money laundering.
What sort of budget have you got to spend here? I mean, how much do you think you're going to need to spend on this house?
Well, we can picture between 150 to probably 200,000 completely. Mm. It's a big budget. I'd try to probably keep it between 150 to 125, but it depends on what specifications you are. Because there's a huge space, if you go for high spec, you can spend up to 200,000.
So who do you think you'll be likely to sell this onto or let it out to?
It would definitely be families. It would probably be sold, not rental. Rental wouldn't be the best option. The best option would be to sell it on.
Now, the last time we met, you kept going on and on about your builders, about the dream team and how fabulous they were. What I want to know is, have you still got the same team, and are they still as dreamy?
I'm still working with my dream team. They're working hard. You know, my granddad used to say you have to have a good accountant, solicitors, builders, and you definitely need a good doctor to look after your health.
You've got most of those all covered, and a cracking dad as well.
Excellent. Thank you so much.
So everything's working out so far. You're in a hurry, obviously, to get the work done. Realistically, how many months is it going to take you?
I expect to finish in 6 months. So my time frame is probably 6 to 7 months. I'm really going to be pushing it on this.
Shaz and Parvez, it's been lovely meeting you both again, and I'm so glad that you've brought your great dad along to meet me.
Yeah, he's definitely an inspiration to me, and so is your program. I hope it inspires many people to get on the property ladder and own their own home.
Oh, well, that's lovely to hear you say, so congratulations.
Thank you so much.
I can't wait to see
the
outcome.
You.
Lovely to meet you. Well, it's great to hear that all is still going well for Shaz as he continues the property developing family tradition. And it's just so lovely to meet his inspirational dad, Parvez. I just can't wait to see the outcome of his ambitious extension plans. Join me later on in the programme and you can see for yourselves how it all goes. Sometimes, no matter how hard you try, well, a plan just, well, it just won't come together.
Nope. How many property projects become derailed? Ooh, quite a few.
Yes, time, money, life just gets in the way. But how did our next two buyers get on? Let's find out.
And so to Chesterton, near Newcastle and the Lyme, where earlier I saw this three-bed mid-terrace house guided at £55,000. Lots of potential on offer here, but a bit rough round the edges.
Look at this. decorative plasterwork on the walls. Actually, it's really, really hard. I mean, if you had a child falling on that, I think they might actually even hurt themselves.
On the ground floor, there was the option to open out the kitchen into the dining room. And upstairs, perhaps move a few walls to create a bigger family bathroom. So, above ground, everything appeared straightforward. Underneath the floorboards, though, not so much.
In a lot of areas around here that were places where a lot of mining went on, some of the excess stuff from that mining actually ended up as the sort of stuff underneath floors, and over time that can cause a bit of a problem. So you definitely need to have that checked out.
It was Sue and Bill who decided to take this on, paying £75,000 in a fiercely contested auction battle. They weren't that concerned with what may lie beneath their feet.
It's been mortgaged since 1965, was it? And the people has owned it, we're in it till now.
But as a long-term rental investment, the couple planned to spend £5,000 on the renovation, hoping to complete the project in 8 to 10 weeks. Well, we're back 5 months later to see how they got on. It may have taken them almost twice as long as they had intended, but the wait was certainly worth it. The kitchen looks fantastic, and without the dividing wall is now a kitchen diner. But the job wasn't without its problems.
When we decided to take the units out, all the tiles fell off, the plaster fell off, so we had to take it right back. Then we had to reboard it and plaster ceilings and whatever. Then we decided to do the open plan, take the wall out and make it one big diner, so which makes it work.
Next door in the living room, Sue has been brightening things up with her paintbrush and removing that big old brick fireplace to make way for a more understated marble effect, has also lightened the mood. To finish off, what better than a touch of Las Vegas pizzazz in downtown Chesterton? Upstairs, the bedrooms have been freshened up with decoration and new carpet. And although the bathroom isn't any bigger, it has had a much-needed revamp. Outside, there is little change, so I'm guessing it wasn't the garden that added to their 8 to 10 week schedule.
It took a bit long because obviously I work at the pub, and then finding the time to come in, then stuff was delayed, like plastering and like plumbers. So that added on, and well, I think if everybody came in at the same time, or within 2 weeks of getting it done, I think we could have done it for 10 weeks. But like, because they were all delayed, it was, let's say, 20 weeks, 21 weeks.
This being their third project together, Bill and Sue should be well used to juggling the demands of marital bliss with the stresses of house renovation.
My love and I, we work well together.
This one's been a total...
It's been a challenge.
Ups, you know, top to bottom. It's a good job we don't live in it, really, because... Oh.
We couldn't have lived in it. We couldn't have lived in it because it was like a building site in the beginning, because I thought, God, what have we done?
Mm. We've had a few disagreements, but we've done all right.
I guarantee you, every time I was up a ladder, the phone would ring. It'd be Sue, what are you doing? And you wonder why.
But we've done all right. We've got it there. We've got there, haven't we, in the end? So we've done it.
They've reached the finishing line, but at what cost? Bill estimated a budget of no more than £5,000. How much did the couple end up spending?
£4,500 at the end, and most of the work I've done myself. I think it would have run to about £6,000 if I had to get somebody in, finish bits and bobs off. I could put my hand to anything.
It's really good. He likes doing stuff like that, and I like decorating, so we've made a good team, really. We've had a few arguments, though.
Well, Sue, you can put your feet up for a few minutes because it's time for two local property experts to pop in and appraise the renovated house. Will their valuations match Sue and Bill's expectations?
It's my first time in the property. Certainly from looking at the previous details, the property's been enhanced, walls have been taken out, and it's been finished to a reasonable standard throughout.
I think the changes the vendors made have improved the property, especially opening out the kitchen dining area.
And it seems Bill and Sue were in luck with the red ash. They've had a report giving them the all clear. They've spent a total of £79,500 on this house, so what's it worth on the sales market?
I'd suggest putting the property on the market for an asking price of £94,950 and perhaps looking to achieve in the region of £92,000.
The property is likely to achieve somewhere in the region of £95,000.
And if they were selling, that would mean a pre-tax profit of between £12,500 and £15,500.
I think I'll put it up for 100 and see how we floated on that.
The couple's original intention was to lease the house as a long-term investment. So what rental income could they expect?
I suggest on the rental market it would achieve in the region of £500 per calendar month.
The property is likely to achieve somewhere in the region of £495 per calendar month on the rental market.
That would give a respectable yield of around 7.5%. So have those valuations changed their plans?
It's difficult.
We've got to have a good think about what we want to do, haven't we?
Yeah.
Because if we want to do it again, which we'd like to, we need to sell, don't we? Mm.
Now to the town of Thornton Heath, Croydon, South London, where earlier I saw this three-bedroom linked semi with plenty of options for extending. Upwards to the loft, backwards into the huge garden, and sideways over the linked garage. No stranger to the show, Shaz brought along his dad, Parvez, to meet me. It turned out there was quite a dynasty of property developers in the family.
I was taught by my dad, and, you know, it's passed on since the generations. Property at that days was about 3,000 for a six-bedroom house.
But the three generations have seen quite a change. Shaz paid £442,000 for this 30s three-bedder, with a view to selling on after refurbishing and extending.
So you could convert this property from a three-bedroom to a five-bedroom.
And I take it that is what you're going to do?
Yeah, we've already put plans in.
We're back 7 months later. I can't see any extension. The separate bathroom and toilet arrangement has been knocked through, and there's a new suite. Every centimetre of space is utilised. Two separate reception rooms remain downstairs, but the decor has changed. Whilst the layout has stayed the same, the electrics, the plumbing and plastering have all changed. The front reception room, although somewhere darker, has a warmer feel. The laminate flooring gives continuity to the different areas. The furnishings aren't just room dressings, there's a tenant resident. Not much has changed in the kitchen, more a case of a clean-up of the existing units. The downstairs toilet and utility room have been renovated. And the clean lines of the laminate hall and stairs complete the downstairs refurbishment. Everything is brighter now. Upstairs, there's a darker tone of laminate throughout. This and a contrasting light decor makes the master bedroom, albeit with the same wardrobes, much more appealing than it once was. The same can be said of bedroom two. And finally, bedroom three. Well, not hard to improve that one. All new doors complete the upstairs look. Over to Shaz now, but be warned, he's a bit of a practical joker.
As you can see, we put brand new porcelain tiles in here. It's really appealing. We've got a nice hotel-style jacuzzi bathtub. You can play music and you can relax in there for hours. We also added a shower, which can accommodate two people.
Calm down, Shaz. Remember, your dad's watching. Speaking of Parvez, he did help out with clearing the garden and in an advisory role. So how's that relationship working?
Sometimes I follow his advice, but occasionally I do exactly opposite to what he tells me to do. So it's worked out so far, so...
We believe you, Shaz. Oh, only to be a fly on the wall when he catches you. Now, why aren't there any extensions as planned?
So we applied for planning permission for a extension, loft conversion and side extension, and we were granted that permission. So if I'm selling the house, I'm selling it with these permissions in place. So whoever buys the house, he can also, you know, he'd be willing to pay a premium for this.
The intention was to sell, but we can see you've got a tenant. Why is that?
At the moment, I have a very close friend of mine who's actually, as soon as he saw the house, he wanted to move in. So I've given it to him and rented it out.
What's happened to the £125,000 to £150,000 budget? It must have come in well under.
We spent about £30,000 on the property itself to bring it to this condition. And the rest of the money, which was in the budget, I went and bought myself a Ferrari.
For the sake of Parvez's health, we would like to point out that this is the end of Shaz's jokes. We called in two local estate agents to give us some valuations and views on the property. First up, the chap who saw the house 7 months ago.
The owner's done really well. I think he's made the whole place very light and neutral. He's kept the floor plan pretty much the same. I would have expected him to knock through from the kitchen to the dining room, open that space up, that'll make it a lovely family space. But nevertheless, it's a really nice finish.
Three bedrooms are much better than five bedrooms, and that's the main, really, lifeblood of the area, the three-bedroom housing. That's what people ask us for, because we've got large gardens, semi-detached garages to the side, and this is their expectation. Once you get up to the five bedrooms, there are other choices available, which can be slightly superior.
So it looks like Shaz was right not to extend. What about the market valuation? The house costs £442,000 at auction and a further £30,000 to refurbish, so anything about £472,000 is potentially profitable.
In its current condition, I would market this house for £525,000.
This property as a three-bedroom house, without the extensions, would sell for approximately £525,000, possibly £530,000.
The top figure has a difference of £58,000 for profit, taxes and expenses. But what does Shaz think?
The right price is probably £575, expecting at least a price of £550 on this. Yeah.
Well, we know that Shaz is already letting the property out, but what do the agents consider to be a fair rent?
This property as a three-bedroom house would rent for approximately £1,600 per calendar month.
For rental, this property would achieve £1,700 per calendar month.
£1,600 is probably on the lower side. We're getting, probably £1,750 at the moment. So that's the fair price, I think, for the condition of the house.
Well, that gives Shaz just over a 4% yield. Not ideal, but Shaz has got a plan for the future.
There's uncertainty because of government regulations coming in, a lot of restrictions on buy-to-let investments, stamp duty surcharges coming in, interest rate tax relief is being discounted from 2017 onwards, and, you know, they're making life so difficult. So I'm diversifying currently into different investments, and I'm not looking at just the UK as a property development sector for me, I'm looking worldwide right now.
Well, the weather may be pretty changeable in this country, but there are no seasons when it comes to buying property.
Yes, but we have plenty of rain and sunshine in all of our stories.
Yeah, so Brolly's at the ready, and join us next time here for more Homes Under the Hammer. Goodbye.
Goodbye.
Goodbye.